Hello everyone, this is a CPE SaaS deployment video. Today we'll walk through how to onboard your CPEs on SaaS. So first thing first, make sure you have the CPE deployment steps with you, and you can find them on the SaaS deployment guide. Go to our website, buysells.com, support, documents, configuration solutions, and you'll find the SaaS deployment guide here. Just download the guide and go through the guide before you start deployment. Then what you want to do is make sure your CPE is on the latest software. So go to support, firmware, CPE, upgrade, and then select the CPE that you want to upgrade. Today I'm going to be using Cat 6 Logain, so I'll show you that. So you can download the software from here. You can also check the release notes, and then you upgrade your CPE to the latest software according to the release notes. Also, you can do the same from OMC. You can upgrade your CPE from the OMC as well, as you all know. After that, what you want to make sure is your eNode B is connected to SaaS and is working with SaaS before you actually connect your CPE. This is to minimize the downtime and also make sure that your CPE is getting the same frequency as what was assigned to your eNode B by SaaS. So therefore, onboard your eNode B on SaaS before you actually do that with the CPE. So as you can see here, my eNode B is onboarded on SaaS, and also the RF status is enabled and it is active. So my eNode B is already onboarded, for which you can follow the eNode B SaaS deployment video we did some time ago. Now I'll open my CPE. So you go to the CPE that you want to onboard, log into it. As you can see, I'm using the CPE model, which is Cat 6 Logain, and also you can see that it's on the latest software. It's not on SaaS right now, but it can connect to the eNode B, which is important. Also, the other thing you want to make sure is your CPE is online on OMC before you onboard it on SaaS. Now, before we start configuration of the CPE on SaaS, let's go to our Google SaaS account and onboard the CPE on the SaaS account before we actually make the configuration on the CPE itself. So remember, CPEs at this point can only do multi-step. So you have to onboard them on your SaaS portal, be it Google, CommScope, Federated, or Amdocs, any of those. You have to first onboard them on the Google SaaS portal or any other SaaS portal before you actually enable SaaS on the device itself. So that's what we're going to do now. Because this is multi-step, this is an important step to follow before actually configuring the CPE. Now, I'm already logged into my Google SaaS portal, which is what I'll be using today. And then now I want to onboard my CPE. So there are two ways I can do that. I can either click on this site mode and then select the location where I want to place it. Or what I can do is use the import method. So when you use the import method, you can actually download the CBSD's template that Google has provided, and you can open that. And then this is the demo template that they have. You can start filling in those details, and you can upload multiple CBSDs at the same time. Be it eNode B or CPE, doesn't matter, any of those, you can onboard or any kind at the same time. So for multiple CBSD import, you can use their CSV format, fill in the information, and then import it to their portal. But today we'll be using the site mode, so I'll just click on site mode, and then you can place the CBSD on your map. So I'm gonna do that. What I'm doing is making sure this is the right eNode B that I want my CPE in front of. Okay, so once you placed your CPE or CBSD on the map, you can fine tune its geolocation as well when you click on the site symbol. I'm going back to the site and I'm going to be filling in all the information here. So this is an outdoor CPE, so category B. You put in your user ID, call sign is not needed, and then you put the FCC ID in. So you can find all our FCC IDs either on the website under support and then product registration, or you can also find everything on the SaaS deployment guide. So here I am on the SaaS deployment guide for Cat6 login. And the FCC ID is here. I'll just copy the FCC ID from here and then go back to my SaaS portal, put the FCC ID in. You can get the serial number from the CPE itself. Copy the serial number, put it in, and then you can find the gain and everything on the SaaS deployment guide. So go back to the SaaS deployment guide and you'll see the gain here. The gain is 11 dBi and the beam width is 70. So I'm gonna go back there and put those information in. 11 dBi, beam width 70. And the EIRP you can find again from the SaaS deployment guide. Is 37, so put that in. And then you can put the physical height. So just for this is in the lab, so taking an example here, but you put the correct height. I'm gonna put 5 meters here, and azimuth should be pointing towards your eNode B. So I'm just gonna put 90 for today. And then if you have any up tilt, you put that in. For today, I'm gonna be putting -2. You don't need the accuracy, you don't need the measurement capability. Select the radio technology, which is EUTRA in this case. You can put the specification, which is LTE, but it's not mandatory to put that in. And once you have all the information filled in, then you just select on sign. Once that is done, you come back to the CPE GUI and then click on System, SaaS. Let me take a minute here. Remember, we're using multi-step, so don't need to put too much information here. Just put your user ID and rest of the information is filled in. So all you have to do is put your user ID. And then click enable on SaaS and then click apply. Once you do that and it says initializing, then you go back to the cloud and check the status. Your CPE will keep attached to the eNode B even through the outdoor registration procedure. So if you made a mistake, you can come back and change it. You'll not lose access to your CPE remotely. So in case you are configuring this remotely, you don't need to worry about losing contact with the CPE. Now go to your cloud account, and this is your serial number. You will find the CPE with the serial number. And then in SaaS here, because the eNode B is already onboarded, you would have the provider selected, but in case you don't, this is where you go to under settings, you change your SaaS provider. Then under advanced SaaS, go to CPE. And here you select your CPE. This is the CPE. So I select that. And then you can find it with the serial number as well. And then you click on procedure. And you see it starts spinning, right? So it will take a few minutes here, because TAN support, as we said, is not available for CPE. So when it comes back to transmission, that mean goes to the whole process and goes to transmission is when your CPE is talking to SAS and the process is complete. So it will take a few minutes here. So it's been a few minutes and now you can see that the eNode B has registered, been granted, and it's getting authorized. Once it's authorized, it will go into the transmission mode and the process will be complete. So there you go, the CPE is now in the transmission mode and it has got its maximum EIRP from SAS. You can check the grant details when you go back to the advanced page. So this is our CPE and you can see it's in the transmission mode and you can see the grant and you can also see the grant expire time here. You can see the same thing on the SAS portal as well. So if you go to your SAS portal, you under status, you will see the grant that has been received by the CPE. In case you want to change your CPE name, you can do that on the portal. In case you just want to give it your serial number for easy identification, you can just put that there and sign it. You can do that before as well. Should not make any difference. So that's the complete procedure to get the CPE onboarded on SAS and connected to the eNode B and getting the same frequency granted as that of the eNode B. Now you'll see on the CPE side as well, it says transmission mode, and then you can, and you'll also see the grant that EIRP that it has got. You can actually select multiple CPEs from OMC and enable SAS on them as well. So this method currently works the best for outdoor CPEs. Indoor CPEs need a little bit of a tweak right now, but for outdoor CPEs, you can select all the CPEs, for example, that you want, and then click on SAS settings. And then put your SAS user ID in that you get from your SAS vendor and then click on OK. And then you can select all the CPEs that you want to enable SAS on. And then what you can do is just click on SAS enable and then SAS process will start automatically on all those CPEs. You don't need to log into the CPE itself. That right now, as I said, it's only working for outdoor CPEs perfectly. All right, so that's it for CPE SAS. Thank you.